Next, we'll study the J.K. Pickup. Write the Verilog code for J.K. Flip Flop. So this is the figure. So this will be a truth table. See, for JK flip flop, like how it will work in the sense, even the JK flip flop also we are going to work in the positive edge of the clock. So now you can see when JK is equal to 0. When JK is equal to 0, 0, then what will happen? Q, that is nothing but there is no change. No change means nothing but Q actually. When J is equal to 0 and K is equal to 1 in the sense, Q is equal to 0 will get. When J is equal to 1, K is equal to 0, Q is equal to 1. Now you can see this, you can compare with the SR flip flop. I hope. Because this truth table and the SR truth table both look like similar only, but the only difference is this condition, toggling condition. In SR flip-flop, what will happen? Yes, both R will be is equal to 1. So it will be unknown condition. We cannot able to predict what the output will get. But to overcome that, what is this in JK flip-flop, what happened? When both are 1, it will toggle the outputs. Toggling in the sense, the value, output value will get changed. That is 0, 1, 0, 1 like that. That is why we written as Q bar actually here. So how we will write the coding now? See, this is the truth table we given. Now let us write the coding for this. I am going to use the coding for using a case statement here. Module JKFF. JKFF. Next, what are the inputs here? J, K. Next, clock signal. Next is Q. If you want Q bar, you can write Q bar. So I'll go for Q. Next, input. Input is 1 colon 0. That is JK. Next input is clock. Next is output is Q. Next is register is Q actually. Next, we have to go for always at passage. Passage clock. Passage clock. Now, begin. Let us start. So, now we are going to use the case statement. So, now case JK. So, what you'll do? 2-B 0, 0. When nothing but JK is equal to 0, 0, then what is Q? Q is equal to Q. That is what we said here. There is no change in the output. Then 2-B 0, 1. Then what is the Q? Q is equal to 0. Then 2-B 1, 0. Then what will be? Q is equal to 1. Next, default condition will go. Because the last condition, default is Q is equal to what? Q is equal to not of Q, that is nothing but a toggling condition. Then we can go for the end case. Then we can go for end. Then we can go for end module. Now you may have a doubt here. Like say, as same question I'm asking. As we done in the SR flip-flop, same in the JK also. When I give initially 0, 0, JK is equal to 0, 0, what will happen the output? There is no change. So automatically what will happen? So the previous output is what? The system doesn't have any previous value. So the system will give you the unknown value, that is nothing but X. So what you have to do in the sense, while doing the simulation, instead of giving 0, 0 in the initial value, you should give as 0, 1. Okay, but how can I write or how can I overcome in that way in the sense? In this program only, I will do small changes. What I can do? So that change is nothing but simple. I'm going to add additional one more input signal here. So that signal is nothing but here, one more signal. Additionally, I'm going to add. Additionally, I'm going to add a one signal. See, here I will add one signal, extra signal I'm going to add. What is this signal in the sense? I will call it as clear. See, I'm going to use clear signal now. Extra. Additionally, I'm going to use clear signal. Now, how can I insert here now? So for that, see, I'm going to add JK clock, then I will add clear here. This is a clear signal I'm adding. Extra, additionally, I'm adding here. So what I will do, let me show this. Okay. Next input, clock, comma, clear. Yes, clear. Now what I should do, it's input only, right? So now what I will do here, begin. After begin, here I will write as like this. If clear, see, I'm going to write now. If clear, then Q is equal to 0, because you are going to clear the flip-flop actually. If clear is high, means Q is equal to 0. So next it will go like this. Then after the end case, I should use for else condition. Then what is Q? If the clear is 0 in the sense, so it should not clear any value, then it's supposed to be what? I can say when clear is equal to 1, the value is X, I can say now here. Else. So now we can see what additional changes I made. You can see the additional thing is I made here. These are the additional statements I added. This is the additional thing I added over there. Now what will happen? How you will draw the waveform here? First, you have to use clock signal. See, very important here, this clear will be is equal to 1 or clear is equal to 0 will happen only during the positive edge of the clock only. That is very, very important. So everything is purely dependent upon the clock only. So what you have to do in the sense, first you should draw the clock signal. So let me explain all these things. It will be very, very clear for you. Then see, this is your clock signal. See, I'm not able to draw properly here. So don't mind this. So this will be your clock signal. Then next, what you have to do? Next, I should draw the clear signal. So as per this, when clear is equal to high, I should clear. So first, what I will do, I'll make clear is equal to high here. Then up to some point, I'll make high. Then I'll make clear is equal to 0 here. Next, I will go for J. Then I will go for K. See, J and K. See, this is and all, I can draw anything, no problem. Just like that, I'm drawing. Even this also. Don't mind this. This is J, this is K. Now let me show how it will be. First you can see this. Rising edge only, right? So what I will do, I will draw a line here. Rising edge point. This is rising edge. These all are we can call the rising edge of your clock signal. This R is the rising edge of the clock signals. If you understood the JK flip-flop, so you can draw anything. Okay, now you can see Q. During the rising edge of the clock, clear is equal to 0. Clear is equal to 0 means what will happen? I'll get as undefined. This place is undefined. Next, during the rising edge of the clock, what happened? You think you think like this only. Yes, from here it is 1. You think in this way. Okay, during the rising edge, clock clear is 1. When the clear is equal to 1 in the sense, automatically you see clear is equal to 1, what will happen? I made a small mistake here. Okay, If clear is equal to 1, the Q is equal to 0, else, a small mistake I did. Yes. So because first you need to clear the flip-flop. Okay, clear is equal to 1, Q is equal to 0. See, when clear is equal to 1, what happened? Q is equal to 0, Q is 0. The Q will be 0 till the next edge of the clock. During this edge of the clock, you see there, Arama computing. During this edge of the clock, now again you have to check what is the clear. The clear is equal to 1. Now if the clear is equal to 1, again you can see what happened. Still clear is equal to 1 means 0. And so what I will do, let me redraw this signal actually, because very, very important this one. Yes. So what I will do, clear is equal to 1 up to here, then I will make 0, then here I will make as 1. This is okay. Now you see, clear is equal to 1 up to here, only clear is equal to 1, so Q is 0. After that, you see, during this edge of the clock, the clear is equal to 0. The clear is equal to 0, and this is what happened. Automatically, it will go to the K statement. So now here you check what is the J and what is the K. Now you see, what is J during this time? It is 0. Even this also 0. So J, K both are 0 in the sense. Now what is Q? Q is Q. What is the Q? It's a previous value. What is the previous value? It was 0. This 0 will maintain till next edge of the clock. Next you see, during this edge of the clock, now check again, clear is 0. Now you check here, J is 1, K is 1. So J is 1 and the K is 1 in the sense, what will happen? It is toggling. Toggling means Q is nothing but not of Q. So the previously the Q was what? 0. Then automatically this will become as 1. This 1 will maintain till next edge of the clock. Now you have to see during this edge. In this edge, what is, again you see clear, clear is 0 only. Okay, then what is J is 1, K is 1 again. Not 1. Okay, you assume as like this only, 1 only. So don't take the 0, okay? You consider like this. 1 only, 1, 1. So still it is in the toggling condition only. So what happened? Again, it will go to 0. This 0 will maintain till the next stage of the clock. This stage of the clock. Now in this stage of the clock, again you see, J is 0, K is 1. When J is 0, K is 1 in the sense, what I should get? Q is 0 I should get. So again, this 0 will be for next edge of the clock. So each and every edge of the clock, you have to see what is the input, based on that output waveform you have to draw. This is what I meant actually. So like this only, so that is the toggling condition. Toggling condition in the sense, you have to see J equal to 1, K equal to 1 in the sense, for 5 clock pulses, for 5 clock pulses, the Q will become a 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, like this it will come. So now we'll see the T flip flop. Now this is the T flip flop, the clock signal, the T input, Q, Q bar. Now what is the truth table will be there? Very simple, we can see T is a single input, right? We'll have the two combinations. I'd say for example, everything is working on rising edge of the clock only, that you have to keep it in your mind. So even we can work on the falling edge of the clock also, but we are working on the rising edge of the clock. Now you can see here the clock is not mentioned over there. Now T, there is a present state, that is nothing but your present output. The next state is always, as you know, it's an output. Normally you can remember your characteristic table, right? So what I will do, same thing I will write here better for your understanding purpose. T, Q, simple I will write. See, first when T is equal to 0, when T is equal to 0, what will be your Q? Q will be remain same, because how we will get this T flip-flop normally? Very simple, JK is there, right? So this J and this K should be short circuited, then we'll name it as T, because JK is equal to 1, then we'll get toggles. So if I apply 1, then that will become as T flip-flop. That is what here we done. So the first
t is equal to 0 1 t is equal to 0 in the sense meaning is what jk is 0 see this see these two only you have to take in the truth table what is that now 0 0 means 0 then this will be 1 so the same we are writing here 0 here what will get there is no change means it is a q only when t is 1 means it will be nothing but q bar
this is the truth table for the t flip flop you may think so many of the people will think like this when t is equal to 0 q is equal to 1 when t is equal to 1 q is equal to 0 this is what your earlier people also used to say when you ask the truth table for t flip flop always you should write the truth table as like this only when t is equal to 0 the q is remains same that is a previous value that is nothing but q it can be either 0 or it can be 1 also that is what we written here you see t is equal to 0 the previous value is 0 so the output will be 0 when t is equal to 0 if the previous value is 1 then I will get as 1 see that is why we are saying if it is 1 t is equal to 1 if the previous value is 0 then it will get toggle will become as 1 then same t is equal to 1 if the previous value is 1 then you get toggle it is 0 that is what we written like this here so now what you do how to write the coding for this so very simple let us write the coding now module start with the module eff that is nothing but input is t next is clock next is q next is input t input clock output q register q and always at pause h clock begin now how to write now if t see what is the meaning of this t is equal to 1 that is the meaning if t then what is q q is q q is q actually right due to the system it's taking by auto caps actually next else what is q q is equal to not of q that meaning is what when t is equal to sorry when t is equal to 1 it is q is not of q when t is equal to 0 the q is q then we can close with the end then we can close with end module see this is the simple program for t flip flop this is a very simple program using even you can write this using the case statement also you can write how you can write using case statement now let me show how to write using case statement see only this portion I will replace it so this you can replace it I will write as in case statement so how to write in case case t so 1 dash b 1 colon q is equal to not of q default q is equal to q end yes I hope you understood this see very simple using statement using case statement how we can write the t flip flop so now in the shift register you can see you are having totally different four different types of shift registers are there I hope you remember the one is nothing but serial in serial out the one is serial in serial out the second will be serial in parallel out then third is parallel in serial out fourth one is parallel in parallel out totally four different types of shift registers are there we are not going to study all those things just I'll going to give very simple input for the shift registers so here we need to write the program for this how we can write the input we are going to give very important you can give any number of inputs correct so as of now what I will do in the sense let us consider we are going to give the inputs as scalar value
that is any one input. What I will do, I'll consider the input is attribute D.
It is a single bit I'm going to do, but the output is 4 bit. The 4 bit shift register means output is 4 bit actually. So reset is required. Why the reset is required? Initially you need to clear all the flops. That is the flip flops. You need to clear it. You need to clear. So everything will be happen during clock only, everything.
So now let us do that.